çok.
Amerika Birleşik Devletleri'nin Suriye özel temsilcisi James Jeffrey, Esad rejiminin çok uzun süredir devam eden saldırıları var. Esad rejimi artık varlığını sürdüremez dedi. Amerika Birleşik Devletleri'nin Birleşmiş Milletler daimi temsilcisi Kelly Craft ve Suriye özel temsilcisi James Jeffrey, Suriyelilere yapılan insani yardımları yerinde görmek üzere Hatay'a geldi. Craft ve Jeffrey'e Birleşmiş Milletler daimi temsilcisi Sinirlioğlu ile Amerika Birleşik Devletleri'nin Ankara Büyükelçisi David Starfield de eşlik etti. Amerikalı yetkililer ilk olarak Birleşmiş Milletler'in yardımlarının Suriyelilere dağıtıldığı Reyhanlı'daki lojistik merkezine giderek aralarında insani işlerden sorumlu Birleşmiş Milletler Genel Sekreter Yardımcısı Mark Lowcock'un da bulunduğu Birleşmiş Milletler yetkililerinden buradaki çalışmalar hakkında bilgi aldı.
Ömer kadın şeydi Ömer, kampa yürüyor, yanına koşmuyor o zaman abi.
We don't need it to be like that. There's no comment now. Yeah, but it would. We're not for like 30 more minutes, so let's wait.
See you tomorrow.
Great to see you. See you tomorrow.
Yeah, not right now, no. Later, sonra. Like, sonra. Yeah. Nothing now.
That's what we tell you, but we don't make that expression
twice from last month.
We are
rationing
back.
Are you still filming?
No, that's not filming.
Amerikalı heyet daha sonra Cilvegözü sınır kapısında Hatay valisi Rahmi Doğan ile görüştü. Craft ve Jeffrey temaslarını tamamladıktan sonra Reyhanlı'dan ayrıldı. İnsani yardımların sınırdan geçirilerek ulaştırılmasına yönelik çalışmaları da yerinde gören heyet, Suriyelilerin kaldığı kampı da ziyaret etti. James Jeffrey ile Suriye sınırına giden Amerika Birleşik Devletleri'nin Birleşmiş Milletler daimi temsilcisi Kelly Craft, geçici barınma merkezini gezdikten sonra basın mensuplarına açıklamalarda bulundu.
This is not something that just is happenstance. This is something that the Assad regime is brutally planned. They want no one in the camps. They want no one here. They want to be able to govern less people. Assad regime cannot exist, and we need to stress to the Turkish government and to the Russian government that they need to come to a ceasefire. They need to come to an agreement. But like I said, today was a very important day, meeting with the white helmets, which was a highlight, especially coming from being the ambassador to Canada and being engaged in bringing many of their families to Canada through Israel and Jordan. And that was a very special moment for me, and meeting with the women who work here and learning about the importance of their being teachers, teaching all of the orphans, and the future for the children. How important it was for these women to establish a future for these children that are here in the camp. And I just cannot stress enough that I'm walking away, I'm the beneficiary of the most aid, because it's what you can't buy, and that is knowing that America, it sometimes is the last best hope. And we are very fortunate, and my appreciation again to the Turkish government for everything they have done to arrange this visit. And I'm happy to take questions, and happy for Ambassador Jeffries and Satterfield to also speak.
Yeah, let me start with that. First of all, on those hills over there, the Turkish military and the Syrian opposition are, first of all, fighting to prevent a humanitarian catastrophe. Millions and millions of refugees. That's the intent of Assad and his Russian and Iranian allies. Secondly, They are fighting to ensure that there will be a peaceful, not a peaceful, but a political settlement to this conflict under terms of UN Resolution 2254, which Ambassador Kelly Craft works very hard in the United Nations Security Council to ensure is implemented properly. So that's what's going on the ground. Turkey has asked for help from NATO. They've asked for help from us. First of all, humanitarian help that Ambassador Kraft talked about. Secondly, as NATO allies, we share information. Turkey is a major purchaser of American weapon systems. As the President said recently, we'll provide supplies and other things to Turkey. We're also looking at other requests that Turkey has made either to us or to NATO as this conflict goes on. David?
No, same comment. We're considering, NATO allies are considering all of Turkey's requests. We're actively doing what we can to support those requests in the North Atlantic Council, in Brussels, and elsewhere.
And I think I'll just say one more thing. I think that the most important part is for when I return to the Security Council to really stress the fact that we must keep the two border crossings open, and the importance of the humanitarian aid reaching the Syrian displaced citizens both in Turkey and in Syria. And that's what's really important, is to start the dialogue now before the border crossings come up in July. And this was the main reason for coming, is to make certain that the humanitarian aid is being received and that we really stress to keep the two border crossings open and perhaps a third opening.
Absolutely.
Well, we are hopeful the Secretary General has identified a border crossing that we are very hopeful that in July we can discuss with the Security Council. But our main thing is we must keep the two border crossings existing open.
There is a possibility that there's going to be a pressure to renew the agreement to keep those two open and open an additional one.
There will be a major push to keep the two that are currently operating open. And as the Secretary General's report indicated, he has found a third area that we would be able to use as a border crossing.
Great, that's a wrap. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you all.
Thank you very much.
Başkanımızın başkanı.